Welcome students, I am Mrs. R. Anuradha, Assistant Professor, Department of History. Now you are going to get a different experience with the topic, the art and architecture of the Pallavas. First, we are going to see a small introduction. Pallavas ruled South India with their capital, Kanchi. The history of the Pallavas may be broadly divided into the early Pallavas and the later Pallavas. The art and architecture of the later Pallavas form a very brilliant chapter in the history of South Indian art. Their productions provided the foundation of the Dravidian style. The art of the Pallavas studied under six headings: architecture, sculpture, painting, music, dancing, and drama. First, we are going to see about the first one, architecture. Architecture can broadly be divided into Nahara type, Dravidian type, and Vesara type. Dravidian type. Mahendra Varman introduced a revolutionary change by Dravidian architecture. He carved out the temples from the living rocks. Mandakappattu rocket cave inscription says that Mahendra Varman constructed the temples without using the perishable materials like bricks, timber, metal, or mortar. Divisions of architecture. The architecture of the Pallava period may be broadly divided into three divisions: rocket caves, monolithic rathas, and structural temples. The rocket cave temples further divided into Mahendra Varman type and Narasimha Varman type. The structural temples divided into Rajasimha type and Nandi Varman type. Among the divisions, first we are going to see about the rocket cave temples. Rocket cave temples classified into Mahendra Varman type and Narasimha Varman type. Mahendra Varman type. In these, we are going to see about the Mahendra Varman type. Its first phase, entirely rock cut, comprises moderate size pillared halls with more cells. The front facade has a row of pillars and plasters. The pillars are square at the base and top with octagonal middle section. A heavy bracket provides the capital Dwarapalakas occupied an important position. Next, we are going to see Narasimha Varman group among the rock cut division. The cave carved out by the Narasimha Varman are found at Mamallapuram. These caves vary in dimensions. The cellars are rectangular. The pillars are the main feature of the facade. The second division of the architecture of the Pallavas is the monolithic rathas. The monolithic rathas in the same style as the mandapas are clearly copies of wooden structures. There are 10 rathas among the 8 found at Mamallai. The most famous 5 are called Panchapandava rathas. The other 3 are Ganesha Ratha, Pidari, and Valayakuttai. The Arjuna Ratha and Draupadi Ratha. The Arjuna Ratha, Draupadi Ratha are on the same platform. The Bhima Ratha has a rectangular vimana with a sanctum in the center. The Dharmaraja Ratha is the 3-storied vimana with a garbhagraha in each story. The Sahadeva Ratha is an apsidal temple. Pidari Ratha has an octagonal sigara with the Ganesha Ratha has a rectangular vimana with an Ardha Mandapa in the front. The third division of the architecture of the Pallavas is the structural temples. These temples constructed with the help of the dressed stone masonry. Again, this group falls into two divisions, the Rajasimha group and the Nandi Varman group. First, we see Rajasimha group. Multi-storied vimana appears to be in the descending order like a chariot. On each end, figures of Kalasa and lion are found. Nieces are found with a similar type of linga found in sanctum. Figures of lion are found both on the outer and the inner walls of the temple. They were made out of mortar. With the above mentioned features, the following temples are found: the Seashore Temple, Mukunda Narayana Temple, Shiva Temple. These are all in Mamallai. Kailasana Temple at Kanchi, Vaikuntha Perumal Temple at Kanchi. The Seashore Temple. This is the earliest of the structural temple found at Mamallai. challenging its survival against natural's fury. The Vimana evolves a higher and more rhythmic tower. The three-storied Vimana had a kalasa. The backside of the temple's sanctum contains Anantasayana Vishnu, Kailasanatha temple. The Kailasanatha temple and Vaikuntha Perumal temple are the most perfectly integrated and matured examples of the style, equally noted for their sculptures. Inside this sanctum, a huge linga is found. The most important of the group of the Pallava structures is the Kailasanatha temple, which is one of the most remarkable architectural monument. The Vaikuntha Perumal temple. Vaikuntha Perumal temple, otherwise known as Parameshwara Vinnaharam, was constructed by Nandivarman II. Each of the three-storied Vimana contains a Garbhagraha with standing, sitting and sleeping sculptures of Vishnu. Among the structural temples, Nandivarman group is the second group of architecture. The originality of the Pallava architecture was slowly vanishing. The Linkas, Dwarapalakas, pillars, etc. are different from the earlier group. It is very difficult to identify this group with the early Chola temples. The following are the examples for Nandivarman group: Mukteshwara temple, Matakeshwara temple, Tiruparantakeshwara temple, Airavadishwara temple. These are all at Kanchi. Perumal temple at Kuram, Viratanishwara temple at Tiruthani, Vadamalishwara temple at Varagadam, Parasurameshwara temple at Gudimallam. Next, sculpture. Beautiful sculptures are found in the temples above noticed. The early Mahindravarman sculpture are tall. Monolithic animals like bull, lion, elephant and monkey family are at Mamallai. The battle scene of Mahishasura Mardini and the Anantasayana of Vishnu and the panel depicting Arjuna's penance are remarkable. Painting. Mahendravarman's taste for painting is depicted through his title Chitrakarapuli. He was the author of the treatise on painting. Is also proved by Dakshyachitra, an inscription found at Mamandur. Trace of paintings on the roof of Kudimiyan Malai, on the wall of Kailasanatha temple, Adivaraha cave and Mamandur cave, etc. are found. Music. Singing of Devaram was practiced in the temples. Sri Vadya Vidyadhar, Sangirana Jadi, etc. are the titles of Mahendravarman. The Kudumiyan Malai inscriptions and Tirumayam inscriptions are musical notes. Yal, Kural, Veena, Takkai, Muravam, Udukai are the names of the musical instruments found in the Devaram hymns. Dancing. Various poses of the Nataracha at Kailasanatha temple speak their taste over dance. Dancing girls were there in the temples. Mukteshwara temple itself had 24 dancing girls. Drama. Mahendravarman's Mattavilasa Prahasana is a beautiful social drama written in Sanskrit. In Perungadai, Manikavasagar says, Nadagathal Unnadiyar Pol Nadithu. Dancing groups also entertained the king in the court. A panel in the Vaikuntha Perumal temple depicts this. Conclusion. So, Pallavas rendered a wonderful contribution to the art and architecture of South India. Thank you for listening.